беше 5000 лева. Обаче аз заготвих, скоро ми играх 1600, но стигнаха до 700 и взех да им давам. Като стигнах 7 магазина, викам, аз нямам повече пари, може ли с 100? Не, не може. И парите да отидох и всичко. И така се скава план. Как се правят магазините? Значи те изпомпват от малки производители.
What event did you organize today and who attended it?
Today we had a seminar with farmers and consumers. The main topic was food sovereignty, and we tried to think about what kind of problems the farmer have and what kind of problems the consumer have and how we can work all together to resolve them.
Can you name a few problems that producers and consumers face in Bulgaria?
The main problem for the consumers is that they don't have access to quality food, or if they find it in the city, it's very expensive. It's certified, organic certified, and it's expensive. In the same time, the small producer has just the opposite problem. They don't have customers who wants to buy their products, so they have to sell it to the big chains, big shops, and they don't earn enough money from this. It's not fair for them to sell it. Sometimes they prefer to throw it out, but not to sell it. And one of the solution of this is to work in the so-called food cooperatives. So the idea is that the consumers can meet the producers directly without anyone between them.
Do you have experience with food cooperatives already?
We already have some experience with food cooperatives. We just started 2 years ago, one of them here in Sofia, and later there is one cooperative which was created in Plovdiv. Still we don't have exact structure and proper solutions of all logistic things, so it's a kind of messy business, but we believe that in few months it will become more organized and everyone will be satisfied from it.
Yeah. What will be the next steps to improve this whole situation concretely?
The next step to improve it is to create a web tool. It's a kind of website which will allow us to have a good communication between us. Everyone from the consumers can create profile, also the producers can create profile, and also the each separate cooperative can create profile, and in we believe that this will give the people opportunity to connect each other and to find common things to do. Like if you are looking for potatoes, it will be very easy to go inside and to see who is selling potatoes now. If you plan to plant potatoes, you can ask them, do you think that this price is fair? I'll have them in, let's say, in September. Do you think that you need them? So the communication which will be much better.
Do the small-scale and medium-sized farmers have an association in Bulgaria? Are they organized?
One of the big problems of small and medium-scale farmers is that they don't have association. In the past we had some, but they were created from the up. It was not grassroots, and they are not functional. It's like they exist but don't function really to help the small farmers to solve their problems. And we believe that this is a step that they have to do to create association which can represent them. It can represent them before the authorities and also the customers, and also they can exchange experience, practical experience through the association. This event was created with the idea to invite consumers, NGOs, and producers as well. We already had some happenings like this, but they were like more concentrated in exchanging information but not looking for solutions. And this was the first one that we tried to work on the solutions, not only on the problems. And we believe that It will be a good model for working, and we plan in autumn a big event like this. This was a kind of experiment in small scale experiment, and we believe in the autumn we can make a big festival and we can bring more farmers and more producers in general and more customers, more normal people wants to eat normal food.
Okay, good. The last question. I understood that you produce honey.
Oh.
Okay, tell me about this. So you are producer, consumer, and civil society one.
2 years ago, I started to have bees, to become a beekeeper. Nowadays, I don't produce enough even for me. But like my idea is now that I'm learning and experimenting, and I hope that in few years I'll make my my bee farm a little bit bigger so I can sell some honey.
Do you have it in Sofia?
It's near Sofia, in a village near Sofia. It's not really near, 35 kilometers, it's more or less close.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Exactly, are there community gardens already in Sofia?
Not really. We don't have really common gardens here in Sofia. There was an experiment the last year, but later they had some problems with the property of the land, so they have now court case and nobody knows what will happen, so they stopped with the experiment because some people came there and destroyed everything.
Guerrilla gardening, transition towns? Yeah.
Not really. We have some ideas about transition towns, but I don't know anyone who really do something.
Okay, if you have a message to the world,
I don't know.
Something, I don't know, about the potential of Bulgaria in agriculture, because Bulgaria was known former, you know,
yes.
Eastern Europe.
Okay.
What happened to this?
I believe that through the food cooperatives in the future we can see how the farmers in Bulgaria and the consumers in Bulgaria will be satisfied from the food quality and everything regarding the food. Because in the past we had some good traditions, there was a period that we lost them, and I believe that now we are burning them again.